Hi, this is Peter Stanley. Welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you the proper way to mix MasterBlend. Okay, so let me back up a little bit with the name MasterBlend. There's a brand of fertilizer for several different types of fertilizer actually, but different ratios and strengths. The name MasterBlend has kind of become, in the pepper grower world, a sort of a genericized trademark for 4-18-38 tomato fertilizer. And there are a lot of different companies who make it. Right now I'm using the one by Southern Ag. And theirs is, looks like they put a dye in it. But I've also used Greenway Biotech and the MasterBlend brand name. So you can get different brands, but it's all mixes the same way. You often mix it with calcium nitrate and magnesium sulfate, also known as Epsom salt. And there's some tools that I used, and I'll show you those here in just a second. All right, so I just want to give you a close-up of materials I use. Good to have something to measure into. I like these little cups that come with the AeroGarden, the little domes. You can use deli cups or just something that's small and sturdy. Some plastic spoons. Gallon jug, about 3/4 full with warm water. I use tap water. You could use whatever. Scale. This is the scale I use. It's AWS 600, measures to a tenth of a gram. I've used this one scale for several years with no problems. Uses a 500 gram calibration weight. Occasionally it needs to be calibrated, but it's usually only off about a tenth of a gram. And it's like maybe once every several months I'll need to calibrate it. But it's been a really good scale. And the components I mentioned earlier, 4-18-38 tomato fertilizer, often generically referred to as MasterBlend. This is actually the fertilizer that Southern Ag makes, and they put a dye in there, that's why it's green. But I've used a Greenway Biotech brand also and MasterBlend brand. I've gotten the same results with all of the different ones that I've used. And it mixes the same way. But you also need to use Epsom salt, which is magnesium sulfate. You can get this at a grocery store, drugstore, wherever. It's really, really cheap. This was $2.20 for this big bag of it. And calcium nitrate. I bought a 50-pound bag of it kind of foolishly because it'll take forever to use that much. And it absorbs moisture from the air pretty easily. So I broke mine up and I vacuum sealed it, the bags of it. So I just break out what I need. And this one bag, which is relatively not much compared to what I've got, will last for a really long time. When you see how much you actually measure out of it. You can get it on Amazon. Oftentimes all three components are sold together. You don't want to buy the ones that have actually mixed together, but if they're separate bags, sold as a package, that's ideal. And it's always going to be a 2:1:2 ratio. So if you do 2 grams of this, use 1 gram of Epsom salt and 2 grams of calcium nitrate. And you just scale that up or down. Like if it's 1.6 grams of this, you'd use 0.8 grams of Epsom salt and 1.6 of calcium nitrate. So that's how I mix mine. 2 grams of the MasterBlend is generally what I use for my general purpose. Peppers, you can go up or down. For seedlings or starting seeds, I'd cut that in half at least, maybe a little more. It's easy to just kind of dilute what you make or just make a smaller, just adjust your scale. So if you're doing a half strength size, just do 1 gram of this, 0.5 grams, and then 1 gram of calcium nitrate. So it's easy enough to do. Yeah, I got 50 pounds of this as well, and I really wish I hadn't, but it was super cheap. It's less than $1 per pound through Southern Ag, but I recommend the sets that have 2 pounds of MasterBlend, 2 pounds of calcium nitrate, and a pound of Epsom salts. That's a 5-pound pack, and that really lasts you. Some people would last them for years, depending on how much you use, of course. That would be a good starting point, and it's relatively inexpensive, around between $20 and $25 probably, because it fluctuates. But so I also have a article on my website that details all of this stuff as well, so I'll put a link to that in the description. It has links to all the products you would need. Also, it's good to have something to test your mix with. I really like that for the PPM or strength. I use the Blue Lab Truncheon. It's a really good tool, never needs calibrating. It's one of those things that just works. And it gives you different scales, depending on how you want to read it. And it just lights up to that level. So for all practical purposes, this is all you need. Also, it's good to check your pH. I've been using this Epra Instruments meter. That's been a really good pH meter. With my tap water, it usually comes out relatively close to what I want. I might need to adjust it up or down, but that's something that's good to know. So you know, once you mix a few batches, you'll kind of have an idea if you're going to need to. In some cases, depending on what it is, but in some cases, you don't even need to adjust anything, depending on where it comes out to. I usually try to keep mine around 6.0, give or take 0.5. So anywhere from like 5.5 to 6.5 is generally acceptable for what I do. So anyway, yeah, I like this meter. I just want to make a mention too, the Epra has a note in their manual to only use the 3M KCL. So that's what I use, and I have it as far as like storage. That's what I keep it in, so the probe stays submerged. It comes with a little carrying case that you could put it in, but since I keep it stored in solution, I keep it upright. For mine, I just kind of wedge it down in here. Keeps it upright, and that works. So that's everything I use, and let's go ahead and get started, and I'll show you how I'll mix these. Show you the scales. This is what I use here. I always check it with a calibration weight. Yeah, that's like I said before, it comes off by a tenth of a gram. I calibrate it. Best mode key again. Just calibration weight. So that's it. So it should register 500. It does. So now we're ready to measure. The way I do it, I mentioned maybe earlier, but I mix the Master Blend and then the Epsom salt, and then the calcium nitrate. And I've got this filled 3/4 of the way with water. I forgot to mention, you need a funnel to put stuff in. Once you see how much it takes to make a gallon, you'll see how ridiculous this much is. So it's, so I'll take a clean spoon. Just a tiny, little bit. So we're going for 2 grams of this. It goes over. Just take some out and put it back in. There we go. And then we just pour this in here. And then I use a clean spoon and a clean cup to mix the next. And you could really shake this up each time, but since we're doing a diluted amount and a gallon and it's warm, I generally will mix the at least the Master Blend and Epsom salt, shake it, and then I add the calcium nitrate. So next is the magnesium sulfate or Epsom salt. And this we're going to mix just 1 gram, or measure just 1 gram. Always go over. Okay. So we dump that in there. Set that cup to the side, spoon. Always keep the cups and spoons separate. You don't want to cross-contaminate your chemicals. And at this point, I'll just give it a little shake. Make sure there's no sediment. And then I'll mix the calcium nitrate in. I wish this particular batch was finer, kind of large pieces there. So anyway, so I want 2 grams of this. You can get some that's finer ground than that. Really, like a tenth of a gram probably doesn't make that big of a difference, but I like to be as exact as I can so that I like to get reproducible results, so that's why I carefully measure things. But so here we go, we add this to it. Always seal your bags up, get as much air out as you can. We just need to shake this up. Using warm water helps it dissolve better. So that looks fine. There's no sediment left to tell. Let's make an extra shake. Yes, that's good. So all I have to do here is just top it up with water. And then that'll be mixed. Let's go ahead and do that, and we'll get some measurements on the pH and strength. Okay, so I fill this up. Tip I wanted to mention about the scale. It's good to have it on a flat, hard surface when you're weighing, and don't have it like sitting on carpet or paper towels, so you'll get a more accurate reading if you just have it on the table. And these are really cheap. They're like $7 or $8, give or take. The calibration weight actually cost more than the scales did. But I'll put links to where I got these. Okay, so back to this. So I filled this up, topped it up with water. Get a strength reading using the Blue Lab truncheon. So usually let it kind of settle a little bit, because sometimes it'll take a second to adjust. But this is reading so far between settling in about 600 ppm. That's what I get with my tap water and 2 grams per gallon of the MasterBlend and the respective other ingredients. So on the pH, 5.3. So I could bring that up a little bit. It's actually not terrible, because sometimes that pH goes up anyway, at least the ones I grow, like the as I use up the excess nutrients, I usually tend to get a shift upward. So if it's a little under my target, it's probably fine. So 5.3, I'd probably actually leave it for me. It wouldn't hurt to bump that up to about 5.8, 5.9. And to do that, you would just use some pH up, and you can buy pH up and pH down in the grocery store or Amazon. I'll put some links to where you can get that. Okay, so these are all plants that are getting MasterBlend. This is a ghostly jalapeno. It's quite a few fruits on it. This is a peri-peri landium. It's an annual strain of peri-peri. And this beast here is a Kingstar lemon starburst. It's pretty loaded. And this is another ghostly jalapeno. It needs some support. It's kind of flopping around, but it actually wasn't getting MasterBlend originally, but now it is. But it's over here now. So So it's one of my go-to nutrients. I usually use this or Donagrow. It's a little more work mixing the MasterBlend, but I get good results with it. And this is the same strength that I mixed in the earlier that I showed. All right, so thank you very much for watching. Hope you like that. Please like, comment, and subscribe.